Alright guys, we're gonna get started. I found my paintbrush. Alright, I'm gonna start with just my round brush here. I guess it's like I would say it's a medium round brush. Here's the photo, the inspiration of a rock. So I think I'm gonna stay true to the colors. I like the way the green is against the pink. So that is what we're going to shoot for. I'm going to start with the butterfly. And I'm going to start just filling it in here with this bright green. I'm trying to put this in the picture some so you guys can see what I'm looking at. I'm going to go ahead and go almost all the way over to this side, even though it's black. Just because I don't want there to be any white in between, and the black will cover that, the green up easily, so. Alright, same thing up here. I'm going to go ahead and just take it to the edge. And just knowing that the black will cover it when I add that in. I like this green. This is probably one of my favorite bright greens. Sorry about my voice. I had lost it last week, and it's just now starting to heal up. Alright, so I'm painting along the edges there. I am not watering down my paint. I'm just using it as is out of the bottle. I do the same thing on this side for these little wings. I've been wanting to paint the butterfly for a while, and it had other projects going on, so I'm excited to try my hand at this, see how it goes. Alright, I'm going to do this last wing here. Alright. I'm going to go on in with my little bit darker green. You can see how there's some shadows created in towards where the top wings go over the bottom wings. So I'm going to get a little bit of the dark green and add it in at the bottom. I wiped my brush a little bit so that I don't get too much paint, because I still want that bright green to really show through. So I'm going to get a little bit more and go on and come over here and do the same thing. That's looking nice. You just want kind of that subtle shadow. There's some variations in the green. Excuse me, in the green up here too. So let's go on and throw in a little up there. And you know, it doesn't have to be perfect. I want to. My own personal goal is to get kind of as close to the picture as I can. But if you don't, that's okay too. No one's going to be seeing the photo you looked off of. They're just going to see the actual product. So have fun with it and do whatever you want with it. That's what I like to do. Okay. And I'm going to do the same on this wing too, just add in a little bit up here of the darker green. Just bring it down into the the lime green until you're happy with it. Alright, now, sorry, I keep hitting my camera thing. All right, now we're gonna move into the black. So I'm just getting a little bit on there. Just gonna go right in with it. And I'm just kind of eyeballing where I want the black to go as compared to the picture. So I'm using the green that I painted on as kind of a general guide. Got a little bit of an edge up here. So I'm gonna so sorry about my voice. Bring that down some. If you wanted to draw out the black, like where exactly you wanted your colors beforehand, you can too. If you paint easier that way, giving yourself those boundaries. Sometimes I do, it just depends. Depends on the particular picture. With these, I felt comfortable and drawing in my own with the paintbrush. So, all right. So this up here is kind of excuse me, bumpy. So I'm just gonna kind of create a little bit of bumps with my brush. I just kind of zigzagging it a little. And I want just barely an edge down at the bottom of the green to show. All right, I'm gonna go in on the top here. And this is pretty thin where the black is, so I'm gonna really try to use the point of my brush and not get it too thick. If it's easier for you to use a finer brush, you can do that too. My round brush, the tip, gets small enough for me most of the time. So it's my preferred brush to paint with. I paint with this one more than I do all others, so it's kind of just easier for me to use it to do all the things with. I'm just defining my green shape up there now. Alright. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and trace the black onto the bottom here. If you have trouble with getting a small line like that, you can check out my video on how I fine line. That might be helpful to you. I'll link it below. All right, I'm gonna move down to this wing. So it looks like he's got a patch of black at the bottom of his wing. A little on this edge. We'll do the same on this bottom wing. Alright, and I don't know if you can tell or not, but there is a really subtle black line here too. It's very thin. So I'm going to go ahead and put that in as best as I can. And honestly, I will probably end up going back over this edge because I'll have to fill in my flower, and some of my pink will probably get onto that black line. But we'll go on and throw it in there for now. All right, we'll fill in this big wing. And you all should let me know what you all are painting. All my tutorials so far, I had known what I wanted to do, what I wanted to paint. And this one, I had no idea what I wanted to do. I had finished up, I had painted Laura Croft because I love her. It's my favorite video game, the one that came out a few years ago. And I had thought about doing a tutorial on how I did her, but I wasn't sure how long it would take me. So I didn't, you know, want a portrait video to be super long. But she ended up actually going really quick, so I may try to recreate her and do a tutorial on her. But I've also got some other things in the works that maybe I'll show you guys at the end of this video. Y'all can see what I'm up to. All right, so I'm gonna outline this bottom wing. No, sorry, the top wing. I'm outlining the bottom of the top wing. Do more on him in a little bit. Let's go on and move to the flower. Alright, I'm gonna start in the flowers underneath are darker because the ones on top are getting the most light, and also the petals, the further into the flower they go, the darker they are. So I'm gonna use that as a general guide. So I'm going to start in with my darker pink on some of the bottom petals that are drawn in. Just loosely filling them in. We'll go back in and create some. Actually, we can go on and do that, I guess. I'm getting just a little bit of my lighter pink, and I'm just gonna add in some little kind of stripes. You just want to, you know, give the eye something to look at, variants of shade, because you know, in real life, nothing is really flat. So it always has a tone difference. Going in with some of my lighter pink and just kind of dabbing it in where I want. Okay. Then I added some just dark pink and light pink. I'm just doing this as I see fit kind of deal. These are all pretty similar to how they're all painted, so I may speed this part of the video up so that y'all don't have to sit here and watch me be redundant, since all these will be pretty the same. One thing you want to make sure of is just that there's some kind of tone difference between each petal that is next to another petal. So you don't want, you know, if you have a dark petal on top of a dark petal, they're gonna blend together. So you're gonna wanna break it up with some of the lighter pink. Or darken your bottom pink more. Just something to differentiate between the two. I feel like I'm never gonna get well, you guys. Right. Yeah, your petals will take some time. But that's okay. I'm just literally doing kind of the same thing over and over on each petal. You can tell what I mean by changing the shades of of each petal just slightly, so that, you know, ones that are next to each other like this, that they're not running together.
Thank you.
we have our flower petals done. Let's define those petals. So I'm gonna take my dark pink. Can you all see that? Hang on. Okay. I'm gonna take some dark pink and I'm going to grab just a little bit of black. You're gonna want more pink than black. So you want it to be kind of like a gray pink, right? And we're gonna go in and we're just gonna start edging out some of the petals with this gray pink. And I need to switch brushes. I need a smaller brush. Alright, so I'm gonna go along some of the edges of the petals with this with the gray pink. And in towards the center of some of the flowers, of the petals, I'll use that gray pink to just, give shadowing to the middle. Create a shadow under this wing here with the gray pink. I'm not gonna do this, excuse me, I'm not gonna do this on every flower petal, just some. So some of them are defined, some of them aren't. That just gives it a little more interest. Sorry, my voice is being funny. Crazy allergies. I definitely want more of this gray pink towards the center petals because the shadow, it's darker inside. So I definitely want to give it a little more of that coming from the center as opposed to the tips of the flowers. I don't really have like a method to how I choose, I guess, what petals I want to have more shadow on. I'm mixing some more black pink. I just kind of eyeball it, so I just kind of, I don't know, just wherever I want, fill it in. them. You can probably see how they're just beginning to take a little bit better shape with, as I do these highlights. Some more up here. Got a little thick with that one. My rock is more bumpy on these edges, so there it's a little harder to get a smooth line. Happy with that. So I'm gonna work more on the butterfly. The black is not even, so we need to correct that. And then we need to add in the shadowing and like the dots of the butterfly and his body. So I'm going to get, let me find my brush. Outline this black a little more, like to not show, to show more green along the bottom. And I'm also gonna bring this up more here, like it is in the actual photo. Do the same thing over here, just bring that to more of a defined point like it is in the actual photograph. All right, now I'm gonna grab some of my darker green. And I'm gonna shadow him in a little bit. Just add in a little bit along this bright green. This brush is being a little wonky. Adding in more dark greens just to give it some pop here and there. And over top of the green I just did, I'm going to add in more of the light green. I just want it to blend and look kind of like, you know, like the colors mesh together. So I'm just kind of dotting it into one another. Alright, let's work more on this down here. I'm going to grab some of my bright green and add it to the bottom here. Just because I really want that to be quite bright. And with the darker green, I'm going to start out from the underneath part of the wing and bring it out towards the light green. Grabbing the dark, adding it in. Brush my brush off and then dab so that they're blended together. Okay. This part of his body is black. So I'm going to grab a little black. And I'm just going to define his little body. Is like a yellow, so I'm gonna grab some yellow and fill that in. My brush is being funny, so it's going splaying out in every direction, so I'm gonna have to correct that where it went into the black. Okay, you can see on his body, well, I'm scanning it on. So it's not just yellow, there's like some black kind of giving it a rounded three-dimensional shape to the body. So I'm going to grab a actually I was gonna say black, but let's not do black. I'm gonna grab some brown. I'll do this sable brown. I don't think it really matters what kind of brown. Let's see here. Alright, getting some of that on my brush. And I'm just gonna go along the edge. I've gotta switch brushes again. That one's, I need to throw that one away. Better. I'm gonna add in some more yellow where my other brush messed up. I'm gonna go ahead and go back over that black where the brush hit that. Fill in the background. I'm going to get my big mop brush. brush, this big guy. And I'm just gonna take my greens. This brush is pretty wet. And let's see, we'll start with the darker green first. So I'm just loading my brush with it. And we're just gonna go in and start painting in the green. You could do your background first, but I pretty much never do that because I don't know, as the painting comes together, I might change my mind about how I want it to look, and I don't know, I just prefer the white background. It helps me to see it come together better in my mind for what I want. But if you know exactly what you are wanting before you start, then a background could be really helpful. Time-wise, it would save you a lot of time. And then you wouldn't have to, you know, worry about your edges or things, because I'll have to go back in and define some of my edges that are getting messed up by painting in the background. But I am willing to do that. I do think a blue background would have been really pretty on this too, like a sky blue, but we'll stick with the actual photo. So I've been trying to decide what I want to do next after I get done with these current projects I'm working on. Thinking maybe about doing some characters like Pokemon or Disney, something along those lines. I love you too.
Hey, Miss Lou.
Okay. Now we'll go in with some different color greens. And add in kind of just the different leaves and stuff that you can tell are in the background. So I'm gonna grab my lime green color, and I'm just gonna start throwing in here and there just for some variation to what you're looking at. As you can tell here, it's blurry, so it doesn't have to be anything defined. It's just literally just color. So that the eye is not looking at just blank or flat green.
If you have trouble
fine lining,
you can check out my video tutorial on how I fine line things. But the general idea is you water down your paint and you get a small brush, and that helps it to glide. The watered down paint helps it to glide. But you want to, you know, kind of have your lines as thin as possible. And that's what's going to give you the most natural effect. Just drawing in the petals. I'm getting a little thick on my line there. So, outlining is, you know, pretty time consuming, but in my opinion, it really helps give your drawing just a little something extra. In my opinion, you know, it just kind of finishes things off. And you can do this in several ways. I mean, you don't have to do it with a black outline like I'm doing. You can go in with your darker pinks and whatnot and create, you know, your really defined petals. You know, doing it that way, but I like this way. Just realized I haven't drawn on his antennas. I need to do that. Because a butterfly is not a butterfly without his antennas. Almost done. Got a couple over here. the same thing with his body here. And just defining it. And now I'm going over this part because it's some of my green I got on there into the black. You don't want that. Same thing over here. All right, let's add in our black dots here. So I'm just dabbed my brush in my black paint. And we're gonna add the dots. I'm gonna come in here just a little bit and kind of create a shadow with my black. Do his antennas. So I'm just loading the black on my brush again and do very thin lines. Creating the antenna. I want to add in a little bit of dark green over here just because I don't know, I feel like that's not quite right. I'm going to use my mop brush. I'm going to get, I think it says English Ivy Green. And I'm just going to put that in up there. Because that looks wonky to leave it the straight edge. I'm gonna get my lime green and go along the edge there and blend it out. Guys, think. I hope you like this tutorial. I'm gonna seal this and take a picture, and that'll be done. Let me know if you guys liked this, and also let me know what other tutorials you all would like to see. Thank you.